ఆదికాలుగానే సదాశివంతం గిరిజాసమేతం సురాసురాధిపత్ పాదపద్మం శ్రీ వైద్యనాథం సతతాం సతతం నమామి శ్రీ గురుభ్యో నమః. రెస్పెక్టెడ్ టీచర్స్ అండ్ మై డియర్ ఫ్రెండ్స్, టుడే ఐ ప్రెజెంటింగ్ ఆన్ ఇవాల్యుయేషన్ ఆఫ్ అరటిగా పుష్పం ఫర్ ఇట్స్ అల్సర్ ప్రొటెక్టివ్ ఎఫెక్ట్ ఆన్ అల్బినో ర్యాక్స్. As we know, Varatika is known to the mankind since Vedic period, and it is one of the member of Sudha Varga, widely indicated for the Pitta, Varanamashula, Anandravashula, etc. Though practiced widely, it has to be validated scientifically with changing times and in terms of modern scientific research. Thus, this research has been taken in hand to evaluate Varatika Bhasma for its ulcer protective effect through animal experimentation, a step in drug evaluation discovery. Why we consider animal experiments so important? Even Atharveda says, Yo Ushadhi Nakulo Veda, Yo Varaho Veda, So Asma Vasvehu. The medicine which is effective in Nakula, is effective in Varaha, that only should be given to the humans. So when even our Vedas suggest to do the animal experimentation, we continue the same tradition. But the purpose was to prepare Varatika Bhasma authentically as per the methods mentioned in Dasa classics, to evaluate ulcer protective effect of Varatika Bhasma in mistral albino rats. For this, Varatika was screened from different sources and I selected from Rameshwaram, which was giving all the Grahya Lakshanas, like it was Granthila, Pitabha, Sardhanishka, Bhala, etc. It took almost two Kumarisuras of Bhava and three Gajiputtas. Classically, two Gajiputtas has been told, but we would not reach the Siddhi Lakshanas, so we have given one more putta. And this was not further subjected to experimental study. In experimental study, it is done against Sugral Fate as a test, standard test as Varatika Bhasma and control, where 666 rats has been taken and saline was given from the control. Healthy albino rats were selected from 150 to 200 grams. Animals were procured from Pankaj Enterprises, Bangalore, and housed at SET College of Pharmacy, Harvard. The animals were maintained under the laboratory conditions which controlled environment of temperature. 12 hours light darkness cycle was maintained. The animals was fed the balanced pellet diet as provided by the same Venkatesh Enterprises. 6 animals were taken in each group for experiment and 2-3 animals per cage was maintained. Inclusion criteria was adult healthy albino rats with 150 to 200 grams. Exclusion was unhealthy albino rats or weighing less than 150 or more than 200 grams. Each rat of group 1 received on average 16.75 mg of superfluid diluted in 0.5 to 0.48 ml of distilled water once a day for 6 days. This is the average dose. It has been calculated from 0.0018 through the adult human dose of 70 kg. Each rat of group 2 received 14.46 mg Varatika and each rat of group 3 received saline for 6 days. On 6th day, 9th, the animals were fasted overnight. On the 7th day, standard of sample and control 2 hours prior to the administration of ulcerogen, that is aspirin, only were given. Overnight fasted animals were sacrificed by ether anesthesia 3 hours after the dose of aspirin. Then the abdomen was opened by taking incision through the excavate process and the organs were identified. Then the stomach was elevated. The external surface was studied for hemorrhage, condition and perforation. The stomach was dissected by separating adherent organs. The stomach was opened by taking the incision at greater curvature, washed with normal saline and fixed with 5% formalin. Sections were obtained and embedded in paraffin wax with hemoxylin and mucin stains. Then these were studied by compound microscope for the confirmation of gastric lesions and ulcer. This is the way, the first thing you can see that the dosing of the animals in this section, and this is the fixed stomach. So gastric lesions were counted and mean certain index was calculated as follows. Presence of edema, the result was analyzed into two parameters, ulcer indexing by hand lens and histopathological study. And ulcer index was calculated at 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 with no lesion, hemorrhagic suffusion from 1 to 5 small ulcers up to 3 mm size. Many small ulcers more than 5 or 1 ulcer of more than 3 mm, many ulcers of more than 3 mm, perforated ulcers. The mean ulcer index is shown here, standard test and control. In standard, which was Sugral Fate, the ulcer index was, average ulcer index was 4.5. In test, which was Varatika Bhasma, it was 2.16. In control, which was just given saline, was 39.5. Showing the effect of the drug ulcer index comparison between group 1 and 2. 1 versus 2, p was 0.0269, which is significant at the level of 0.05. It was 2 versus 3, it was p is highly significant, and 1 versus 3 was again it was highly significant. So this was a graph showing the comparison between the three ulcer indexes. In histopathological study, the section of stomach has studied. We have sent to Jeevan Pathological Lab, Belgaum, and they have given the report with mucosal congestion, test standard as mild, whereas control as marked. Mucosal edema, test and standard as mild, where control as marked. Mucosal hemorrhage, daily test and standard present in control group. Discomitation, mild and fecal, focal and test, mild and standard present in control. Neutrophilic infiltration, test and standards as mild, whereas control as marked. Lymphocytic infiltration, test and standard as nil, whereas control as mild. Mucosal ulceration, test and standard as nil, whereas control as marked. Granulation tissue, test and standard as nil, whereas control as marked. Cellular degeneration, test and standard as nil, whereas control as marked. Inflammation, test and standard as mild, whereas control as marked. Overall damage was mild in test and standard group marked in control. This was the study was carefully designed and care was taken right from the selection of paraticides, processing and preparing of plasma. When administered to anaglutinates for ulcer protective effect, it has shown significant result against control, p 0.001. When compared with test drug, sucralfate has shown significant result with p equal to 0.0269. And histopathology also proven the observed data. When we are studying this Varatika Basma, two things came in our mind. Is one, Varatika Basma showed potential ulcer protective effect. So on NACID induced ulcer models. So it can be used as adjuvant in a long-term indication of NACIDs like aspirin. And Varatika Basma is said to be breccia. And NACIDs are known to cause loss of libido. So when it is prescribed for longer duration in diseases such as rheumatoid arthritis, the loss of libido is quite common, this Varatika Basma can be given as adjuvant. The studies can be done. So I really acknowledge and thanks to my friends from SCT College of Dharwad who has worked with me, and because we are not that much connected with them, and they helped a lot to do this study. So this is all what we do. Running away from any problem only increases the distance from the solution. The easy way is to escape from the problem is to solve it. In today's modern world where research is inevitable, this is a way, rather than running away from the research, we have to do the research and prove ourselves in the modern scientific term. We have to find new horizon with a different outlook. So Warren Buffett says, you are neither right or wrong because other people agree with you. You are right because your facts are right and your reasoning is right. That's the only thing that makes you right. And if your facts and reasoning are right, you don't have to worry about anything else.
First the second slide, or the third slide. Yeah, this one. Yeah, this slide. Now, can you explain to me once more the group 1, group 2, group 3?
So group 1, which is sucralfate.
So the group 1 got sucralfate.
Sucralfate.
Which causes ulcer.
No sir, sucralfate is ulcer protective agent which is established. Okay. It has been given with a regimen of every 6 hours, 1 gram, every 6 hours.
Okay, the group 2 was?
Varatika Basma.
And the group 3 was?
Control based only saline also, nothing else.
So why did the saline group get so much of ulcer? Was your environment so bad that all the 6
hours? Sir, actually I asked my co-guide also who is a professor there. Pharmacology. Sir, so, told ki aspirin is very drastic inducing agent. So
all the three groups were given aspirin at the end.
Yes, sir. All the three groups were given. Even control, standard sucralfate and Varatika also got the ulcerogen aspirin. But in that ulcer protection was there because it was given in the last 6 days. We have been feeding the animals with these two drugs. So it is so not.
This design is you pre-treat the animals, yes, with your test drug or,
yes,
sucralfate.
Yes.
And then you induce ulcer and,
yes,
see whether pre-treatment protects it.
Yes, that is what protects.
Not that ulcer has been induced and then you
use
the drug.
No sir.
So maybe I think it would be interesting if you can do this test, create the ulcer first and then give the drug and see what happens.
Isn't that nice?
Because in a practice situation, nobody knows that I am going to get ulcer. Nobody will start taking Varatika Basma as a preventive to ulcer. So the guy has got ulcer, he comes to a Vaidya and the Vaidya will say, okay, I will put you on Varatika Basma. So that situation you have not tried to build it into your model. So it's a suggestion for you.
Sure, sir. We'll
if you can do that and combine both the models and publish, it would be a good study because you have looked at pre-treatment and after the ulcers have formed, you are given the drug and see what does it do. Does it reverse the ulcerogenesis?
So in this study, we are suggesting the varotica also can be given as adjuvant to.
I won't agree with that because the second part data is not this. If the grantha says it protects, you want to use it, please use. Because I can't be better than what grantha has said. But when you are trying to generate a data, I think if you can repeat this, first give aspirin to all the three groups, create ulcers, then you give sucralfate, then you give your drug and a control and see what happens.
Okay, so that will do, sir.
What was the dose of aspirin you used? Because it was a single dose, it generated, means it created so many ulcers.
Ma'am, I think they have given the 4 grams.
Sorry, 500 mg.
Not protective.
Thank you.